No llores, no pierdas la fe, la sed, la calma el que hace. Agua de la arena, y tú que te levantas con orgullo entre las piedras, has hecho mares de este polvo.
I throw stones at my eyes, for too long they've been dry. Plus they see what they shouldn't from oppressed babies and thighs. I throw stones at my tongue, cause shit should really keep its peace. I throw stones at my feet, cause the straying lead to defeat. Couple of big ones at my heart, cause the thing is freezing cold. But my nuff's still alive and kicking, unstoppable on the roll. I throw bricks at the devil, so I'll be sure to hit him. But first at the man in the mirror, so I can chase out the venom.
Little boy, shining ahead. Just another kiss and how to get some bread. Not the first murder, nor the last. Again and again a repetition of the past.
Since the very first day, same story.
Young ones, old ones, some glory. How can it be? Has the whole world turned blind? Or is it just cause it's only affecting my kind? If these walls could speak, imagine what would they say? Me and this path that I walk on, there's only one way. Bones may kill, bones may break.
This is Democracy Now!, democracynow.org, the War and Peace Report. We're broadcasting from Twin Cities Public Television in St. Paul, Minnesota. I'm Amy Goodman. An immigrant rights group based in Minnesota has sued ICE, the U.S. Immigration Customs Enforcement, over its raid last year of the Swift meat packing plant in Worthington, Minnesota. On December 12th, federal agents raided Swift plants across six states. More than 1,200 undocumented workers were arrested overall, including more than 200 workers in Worthington. The lawsuit claims that federal agents insulted, abused, and humiliated the plaintiffs on account of their race. The suit says female Latina workers were ordered to disrobe in front of federal agents during the raid, while white workers were allowed to move about the plant freely. Gloria Contreras-Eden joins me here in St. Paul. We welcome you to Democracy Now!
Thank you, Amy. I appreciate you having me here today.
You are the executive director of Centro Legal, the immigrant rights groups that filed the lawsuit. Can you talk about the lawsuit and the people you represent?
Yes, I can. Thank you. The lawsuit was filed on September 4th of this year, the day after Labor Day, and it's on behalf of 10 plaintiffs who are either U.S. citizens, legal permanent residents, or those who are authorized to work in this country. We are alleging constitutional violations. What's important to recognize in this particular case is that this really wasn't a typical immigration raid. This was part of a criminal investigation that the government had been conducting for possibly over a year. They had a list of people whom they could have gone in, picked up without any disrupt to the companies, to the communities, and they chose not to. And so whenever you're part of a criminal investigation, now I'm not a criminal lawyer, but I know enough to say that when you're part of a criminal investigation, you're afforded certain protections. You're afforded the protection of an unreasonable detention. You're also afforded the protection to have the right to remain silent, the right to counsel. You're also afforded the protection to be able to speak to an attorney if an attorney is available to you. In all these situations, across the country, people were not afforded these rights. And so that's why we filed this lawsuit.
Explain, and we don't have much time, but explain how the raid went down in Worthington.
Well, we know that approximately 100 plus agents descended upon this Swift company packing plant in Worthington, Minnesota. And we know that we also know that the employer, Swift and Company, supervisors were working with the agents and preventing people from leaving the site. So they surrounded the premises with agents and their vehicles. They pulled up approximately six buses to load people up, and then they systematically and procedurally started rounding up people who were of Latino descent. And it's important to recognize here that people who did not look Latino were allowed to roam freely throughout the plant. And so those who were Latino, whether, even if you were a citizen or a resident, were required to prove that they were here lawfully. Now, I personally can't prove that I'm a U.S. citizen. I wouldn't know how to do it. But in this case, they required everyone to do it upon the threat of deportation and removal.
Were people deported?
Yes, they were.
How many?
We don't know how many there were deported because some were deported immediately and some are still under removal proceedings. Our agency is also challenging the constitutionality of the removal proceedings.
And what are you asking for? What are you demanding?
Well, we're asking for injunctive, declaratory, and monetary damages. Now, what that means essentially is when you ask for injunctive relief, you're asking them to stop this conduct, this practice. When you're asking for declaratory relief, you're asking that the federal court declare that this is wrong, unconstitutional, and of course the monetary damages are self-explanatory.
Well, I want to thank you very much for being with us. We will continue to follow this lawsuit and also the activities of the ICE, the Immigration and Customs Enforcement. Thanks for joining
us. Thank you for having me.
Gloria Contreras-Aden, attorney and executive director of Centro Legal, a nonprofit law firm that provides legal services to low-income Latinos in the area of immigration law and family law here in Minnesota. That does it for the broadcast today. I look forward to meeting public radio program directors in Minneapolis tonight. I'll be in Seattle 6:30 at the Social Justice Fund Northwest Annual Dinner at the Seattle Marriott Waterfront. Democracy Now! Is produced by Mike Burke, Aaron Mate, Sharif Abdelkaddous, Nicole Salazar, Steve Martinez, Jeffrey Hagerman, Anjali Kamat, Carrie Mache. Our website is democracynow.org.